Offshore wind development has political backing on a national and state level from both the Biden and Healey administrations. Developers continue to choose New England for their projects. But why New England? Why is this area prime for offshore wind? Storm Team 5 Chief Meteorologist Cindy Fitzgibbon explains the wind patterns of the region.
You're going to have wind on the water because there's no friction to slow the movement of air. But here in New England, we get the added impact of the jet stream, typically near our latitude, the fast river of air high overhead driven by clashing air masses. That affects things near the surface, creating areas of high and low pressure. High pressure is sinking air, low pressure is rising air, and wind is simply air moving from high to low pressure. The faster the air rises up, like in a storm, the faster the air moves in to replace it, and the faster the wind blows.
Offshore wind developer Ørsted has 5 offshore wind projects in the works along the East Coast, but they've been developing offshore wind in Europe for decades.
We built the first wind farm in Europe in 1991. We know it works there. Offshore wind is a super important resource. We have some of the best wind resource anywhere on the planet off the coast of southern New England, and we really do need to tap it.
The offshore turbines harness wind and use it to produce energy. Ørsted's deputy head of construction, Paul Murphy, explains how it gets to the consumer.
Each of the turbines produce energy. That energy from the turbine goes into a cable called an array cable. That then goes to an offshore substation. So then it comes onshore and then it's connected into the grid and used regionally.
Vineyard Wind is the country's first commercial scale offshore wind farm, but not the first overall. Back in 2016, Ørsted installed 5 turbines 4 miles from Block Island in the waters of Rhode Island.
We're really proud of the Block Island Wind Farm. We have been making a lot of progress as an industry, and of course, yeah, taking on board the lessons that we learned from that first really pilot scale project.
Paul Murphy has been working in the offshore wind industry for 10 years. He was there when the Block Island Wind Farm began spinning and is now working on Ørsted's latest project, South Fork Wind, a wind project off Long Island.
So the Block Island turbines are 6-megawatt machines. The turbines that we're installing here for South Fork and for Revolution will be 11 megawatts.
While the science supports the potential of offshore wind, not everyone is happy about the possible negative impacts.
Imagine if a foreign company proposed to build windmill projects in the middle of the Grand Canyon. Yeah.
A group of local activists has been speaking out about Revolution Wind, an Ørsted project off the Rhode Island coast.
Everyone's panicking about climate change, as we all should be. And wind farms come along and this is the answer, or one of the answers, so people embrace it. And that's, we understand that, and we're in some ways, you know, crushing their hope for climate mitigation.
Among the group's concerns, the impact of wind energy projects on fishing habitats.
This has been a particularly sensitive habitat that is critical to Rhode Island and to the fishing industry, and yet it's one of the only remaining spawning grounds for Atlantic cod. They always want to come back to the same area to spawn, and they're very sensitive to noise.
They also question offshore wind's potential to eliminate reliance on fossil fuels. And yet, many states, including Massachusetts and Rhode Island, now mandate that electricity suppliers obtain more energy from renewable sources. And developers insist they're taking the steps needed to pursue wind energy safely. Vineyard Wind CEO Klaus Moeller.
We need to coexist in the ocean with everyone who's out there, whether it's the mammals or it's the fishermen or it's just other traffic, right? For the installation part, we have some of the newest technology to lower the noise. And an example is when we install the foundations, you will see that there's a ring of bubbles around it. And actually that ring is called a bubble curtain. It protects the noise so the noise doesn't travel as far. We've also invested in research for, you know, for new technology. There's camera technology, there's microphones listening for whales. I think it's a positive in many ways. Of course, we take it very, very seriously that no one gets hurt from this project.
And Vineyard Wind executives say that they are really pushing to get the turbine construction completed.
They want to complete it because they're going to halt construction in the winter and early spring when the endangered right whales could be in the area. They also say they plan to track the right whales, and if they are in the vicinity of the turbines, they'll use that noise dampening features to make sure that they don't get affected.
All right, great. Coming up, local ports prime for development.